fans, all my friends. I love going to war with you boys. Let's go.
Well, my odds to make it to NHL were slim, but you just got to party like one day you will make it.
I'm a hometown hero, baby!
My guest today is a man who has walked a unique hockey journey along a winding road from rejection and dejection to character-filled hometown hero, big rig, shirt off, chest out glory. It's an immense joy to welcome Mr. Pat Maroon.
Thanks for having me, Roger. I appreciate it. Good induction.
Pat Maroon, you were born in Oakville, Missouri, just 50 miles down the Mississippi River from St. Louis. A childhood season ticket holder at the St. Louis Blues. You started yourself by playing roller hockey at the age of 5 years old.
That's how I developed the love of hockey. I was a rink rat. My parents would drop me off in the morning and they would pick me up at 4 o'clock. They'd give me $3. I'd go to the snack machine, and that's back then when sodas was 50 cents and 25 cents for chips. So, you know, I had all the money in the world.
You were a big kid back then, one who suffered a cruel nickname.
Fat Pat. I'm just a big guy. There's nothing I can do, and this is who I am, and this is what you're going to get.
And to compensate, you used to grind away in your garage, stick handling a golf ball for hours. One early scout said you could stick handle in a phone booth, but you couldn't fit in one.
Very true. I still can't fit in one. Yeah, I just learned at a young age how to play the game with my mind, my hands. My feet were never there. I wasn't the best skater. I found a way to get the job done. And I always told myself I got to work on the little things, vision, and develop the hockey sense.
You showed enough ability in high school and minor league hockey to be taken by the Flyers, who drafted you at number 161 in the sixth round of the 2007 draft. You experienced a brief glorious moment winning a gold medal for the United States at the 2010 International Ice Hockey Federation Inline Hockey World Championship. But when you returned to the Flyers expecting to be lauded for your triumph, they were instead appalled by your conditioning. Philadelphia's American Hockey League affiliate, the Adirondack Phantoms, sent you home.
It was, you're never going to play for the Flyers organization ever again. So it was tough to swallow.
You were 22 years of age, unemployed. You crashed out on your cousin's couch in New Jersey. You couldn't have been further away from the NHL in that moment. These were some dark days.
I would say embarrassing. You're getting texts, you're getting calls, and you're not responding to them. And people were reading the tabloids at the time of like, what happened to this kid? Like, what did he do now? And I called my dad. I was like, Dad, I think I just want to retire. I think I'm just going to hang him up, because no one's going to take a kid that got sent home. There's days where I would just sit there and just be like, wow, what a disappointment.
And to make the uncertainty even more terrifying, Pat, you were a young father, your son Anthony. He was 2 years old. In your darkest moments, it was the desire to be an example for him that drove you onwards.
Your family's like, hey, listen, you have to provide for your kid. What are you going to do when you go back in the working world? Where are you going to go? And I was just like, well, you have a good point. I do not know where I'm going to go, but I'm going to find a way to figure this out soon, because if I don't figure it out soon, then I'll be living on your couch with my kids. And when you have a two-year-old kid and you're a dad and you want to be a prime example, that's not being an example.
Looking for a second chance, and the Anaheim Ducks organization gave you one. You played for 8 teams over the next 10 years, but it was after arriving in Edmonton, February 2016, that you truly blossomed.
It's Maroon draped on him, and here's Maroon in front. He shoots and scores! Patrick Maroon, the hat trick!
The Oilers gave you a nickname.
Big Rig. I'm just who I am. I'm just a big unit. It's a great nickname. I'm the Big Rig.
Better than Fat Pat. It's a state of mind as much as anything. Off the ice, though, you still had to try and be the best father you could be for Anthony from afar. And your son was now a second grader in the St. Louis area, living with his mum. There was an incredible moment when you came into St. Louis with your Oilers, scored a goal against your childhood team, with then 7-year-old Anthony watching. Post-game, after the Oilers won 3-2 in overtime, Sportsnet interviewed you.
The goal was great, but I wonder what you think of this reaction by your son and family.
Pretty emotional. I don't get to see him as much, and it's pretty special.
Still watching that video chokes me up, because when you're living in Edmonton and your son's in St. Louis, there's no easy flight to get to Edmonton. So seeing that smile again was a relief for me.
All this factored in at the end of that season, you'd racked up a career-high 43 points, hitting your first free agency, first time in your entire pro career that you could choose where you would play. And you, Pat Maroon, took less money to play for your hometown team to be with your son, the Little Rig.
Having that opportunity to be with my son, go to practices, maybe go on the ice with him a little bit. When they first called my name out in the opening night.
Welcome home, St. Louis native number 7, Patrick Maroon.
Got a little emotional. Being home in St. Louis, putting the St. Louis Blues sweater on means a lot to me. You grew up watching the St. Louis Blues, and you look up in the stands and you see your family, and you know your mom and dad can come to every single game, and your buddies are watching. It meant everything to me. It meant the world to me, and every kid dreams of playing for their hometown.
The St. Louis season was one that dreams are made of. You're in last place before vaulting up the standings into a playoff spot where you wove your name into St. Louis sporting lore. Double overtime, game 7, second round, score tied 1-1.
Thomas, shoot! It's behind him! It's not going to go!
I lived a full-on dream that we've talked about my whole childhood. Those moments playing with my brothers in the basement, my son being in the stands, getting emotional, watching me, something I'll never forget, and it'll probably be replayed the rest of my life. So I don't know if I'll ever score a bigger goal than that. It's a childhood dream that a lot of kids can say, I want to be Pat Maroon and score that big goal.
Into the Stanley Cup Final. Game 2. The Blues are 1-0 down in the series against the Bruins. You're on the road.
Then Bortuzzo score! And the game is tied!
St. Louis defenseman Robert Bortuzzo ties it up, partially thanks to your screen. And as you skate back to the bench, the Bruins are chirping. Tell us how you responded, Pat.
I said, you guys are
I mean, those are St. Louis equivalent of Churchillian words. Your prophecy became true.
For the first time in their history, the St. Louis Blues are the Stanley Cup champions.
For the first time in 52 long years, the Blues won the Stanley Cup 4-3. On the ice, afterwards, your son, crying again, hoisted the Stanley Cup. Pat, in a city of millions, you were the chosen one.
I'm not the flashiest guy, but went out there every shift and I earned every shift I could. Everything we dreamed of my whole life, but I did it with my hometown. Can you guys effing believe it?
You were not done. Fresh from a championship in St. Louis, you were signed by the Tampa Bay Lightning, a talent-soaked team, scarred by the memory of the previous season, where they tied an NHL record with 62 wins, only to be swept by the underdog Blue Jackets in the first round of the playoffs. Your advice when you arrived, you actually were very concise, but effective.
It was just, f*** it. There's nothing you can do. I felt their energy, I felt their pain.
You backed up your words with big plays and big moments. And you capped it all off with that classic sunglasses on, shirt off chanting,
I'm the big rig, I'm back to back.
When you look at that clip, that video, which I do almost every day whenever I'm feeling down, when you look at yourself in that moment, shirtless, what do you see?
A drunk human.
You were Tom Brady before Tom Brady was Tom Brady. It's been some journey, Pat Maroon. You have created memories for thousands of young Pat Maroons across St. Louis. Most importantly, your son Anthony, who's now 12 years old. What message about life would you like him to take from it all?
I think he understands now a little bit. He still gets upset when I leave. He just wants me to be with him full time, and I want to be with him. These last few months or last year of quarantining and COVID, I've actually had the opportunity to be with them, and I took advantage of it. And when you have those times, you have those moments, you look back on your career, and this is the most important thing.